Hi everyone, I just want to sing this song called Take Me Into the Holy of Holies. I can't sing loud because it's really late now. And then I want to share a dream that I had in February of 2016. Take me past the outer court, into the holy place, past the brazen altar, not alone to see your face. Take me past the crowds of people, past the priests to sing their praise. A hunger and a thirst for your righteousness is found only in one place. Take me in to the holy of holies, take me in by the blood of the Lamb, take me in to the holy of holies, take the gold, cleanse my lips, here I am, take me past the outer court, into the holy place. Past the brazen altar, not alone to see your face. Take me past the crowds of people, past the priests who sing their praise. A hunger and a thirst for your righteousness is found only in one place. Take me in to the holy of holies. Take me in by the blood of the Lamb, take me in to the holy of holies, take the gold, cleanse my lips, here I am, so take me in to the holy of holies, take me in by the blood of the Lamb, take me in to the holy of holies. Take the coal, cleanse my lips, here I am. Take the coal, cleanse my lips, here I am. Take the coal, cleanse my lips, here I am. Take the coal, cleanse my lips, here I am. Take the coal, cleanse my lips, here I am. Take the coal, cleanse my lips, here I am. In my dream, I'm not very good at talking in front of cameras, but anyway, so in my dream, I go inside this like giant stately home, and inside the big the hall, kind of like as you go through the front door, you're in a big hall, and then I find myself sitting on a settee with a woman at the time. Well, she was my fiance, but we split up, but I'm sitting with her on the settee, and then suddenly I get up and I'm walking with somebody, I don't know who, we walk to, as you go in through the front door of the stately home, you turn to the right, and then there's like a door, and we both go together to this door, and this person who I didn't know who it was, and when we open the door, there's this foul smell that comes up, and we're looking inside quite a large room, rectangular shape, and I realise that the stench is coming up from a carpet. And so I look at this person and say that we need to pull up this carpet, get rid of it. And so we pull up the carpet, and to my dismay, there's another carpet underneath it, and it's even more foul and disgusting. Basically, we have to pull this one up as well. So we do that, and we find there's another carpet underneath that one. Altogether, we end up pulling up 5 layers of carpets, and each one is more rotten than the other. As we pull them up, the one below is even just absolute foul stench. And once we pull up the 5th carpet, we look below, and there's chasm of darkness, and you can't see nothing. And to my horror, I realise the stench is going much deeper than just the carpet. It's coming from down in this lower room. So me and this person, we end up leaving the room and going down the stairs to to the room below. And when we open the door, we're inside a huge hall that's full of light, and as the light kind of like settles, I look inside and I realise it's a church hall, and the church is a church I used to go to in Glasgow. I won't name any names because I don't want it. But it's a church I used to go to in Glasgow, and it's a great kind of like a Methodist style hall. And I wander in and I see all these people from this church, and they're all kind of like sitting at tables, and I realise that I had this sense that this is more than just a church, this is a Masonic meeting. That's what came to me in my dream, a Masonic meeting. It's the real kind of like underlying thing, it's Freemasonry. And as I'm kind of walking from table to table, just observing, I felt like an observer, kind of like, suddenly a woman notices me. And she says, "Alex, are you going to come to our church on Sunday?" And I said, "I can't. I said I'm committed to another church now, which is Prospect Hill Fellowship." I said, "So I can't." She said, "Yeah, but you're still going to come, aren't you, on Sunday?" And I said, "I just told you I'm going to another church. But if I have time after my meeting, if there's time, I'll come along to yours as well." Anyway, so I wander like down the hall, and I'm met by a great fence, is not normally there in this church, but in my dream it's this great fence, and I wanted to see and peer over it and see what's over the other side. And so I found myself climbing up this fence. And normally in this church you've got like the organ pipes, and that's at the front of the church, like normal. But in my dream, they're on the side. And once I climbed up to the top of this fence, I found myself holding onto these pipes to balance myself. I can't quite remember what I saw over the other side, because something else got my attention. And I closed my eyes, and when I opened them again, the pipes were no longer the organ pipes. There was a doorway right in front of me, and it looked like the door of like a submarine or a ship, kind of, you know, rounded edges with a porthole and the kind of like metal, you know, door thing that unseals, because they're always sealed, aren't they? They're sealed tight, you know, to stop water from coming in. And as I looked at this door, the Holy Spirit inside me said, "Worship me, Alex." And so I started singing. And this is what I sang. With a clean hand, I'll praise you. With a pure heart, I will honor you. With a right spirit within me, I will magnify your name. I will magnify your name. I will magnify your name. With a heart that's full of love for you, I will magnify your name. With clean hands, I'll praise you. With a pure heart, I will honor you. With a right spirit within me, I will magnify your name. I will magnify your name. I will magnify your name. With a heart that's full of love for you, I will magnify your name. And that was what I sang. And as I sang that song, the anointing of God came down upon me. And it is so powerful, the glory of God, that it blasted this door right off its hinges and blasted it down this corridor. And when that happened, I felt a revival come. And I just knew, I came down from the fence and I knew that whoever had any sickness or illness, no matter how bad, I knew that when I prayed at that instant, no matter who it was, they would be healed. That's what my dream was. And I believe it was from God. I know, and I feel when a dream's from God, I never forget any detail of it. It's just, and there are certain things within the dream that have significance. I believe the stench is coming, and it's shown, or the Lord has shown me, is something that is in the church. Something foul and something unclean. And it's affected us all. And the Lord wants to deal with the roots of these things. And it was shown to me as Freemasonry, but it could be allegorical to to mean a lot of things, you know. But I just wanted to share that, and I want to, I would ask you to pray about it and see if God shows you anything. And if he does, I'd appreciate it if you would share that. Or comment, leave a comment. Bless you all and good night.